I've got a Miss Violet Smith here to see you, Mr. Holmes.
Every day, I am being followed by a man.
What does he look like?
His identity is hidden. He wears a balaclava.
Do you really think she's in some sort of danger?
Oh, yes. Last night, a brick was thrown through the window of the manor. A letter attached to it, but it did not contain writing. Just these symbols, these drawings. The dancing men.
A child's drawing, perhaps.
The drawings obviously scare Violet.
Of course, Watson! It is not a drawing, it is a cipher! Violet and whoever is the person that is sending these letters know the cipher. Only they know.
And why have you not yet done anything about it?
Because her follower is me.
He was acting as a guard.
Ever since she received the letter, I followed her.
May I suggest you take extra security out on the manor?
Whatever for?
As I was walking from the manor, there was a man in the trees, keeping watch on the manor. Carruthers is dead. Violet Smith has been shot in the head and is in a critical condition. This has to be the last letter that was received by Violet. It has to be.
And what does it say?
Come to me at once at the youth club in Upper Farn. Abe's Lane. Come, Watson.
We need to get out of here, Holmes. The doors are blocked with smoke and fire.
What was your relationship with Miss Smith?
We were lovers back in 2006.
And how did you find her?
I was told by someone.
Who?
James Moriarty. We had a deal. Once I fix your body, I'm out of his debt.
Flynn. How is Violet doing anyway?
She's making a full recovery.
Holmes, I don't have time to explain.
There's a room for you at Baker Street.
Are you asking me to move into Baker Street with you?
Are you sure you're making the right choice here, Holmes?
As the world moves on, my dear Watson, I must move on with it. It has been a difficult year for us all. I think 2021, it's time for me to move on.
Just seems a little bit sudden, that's all, and out of character for you especially.
I will miss these rooms, of course. So many wonderful memories. But things will never be what they once were. It is time for a fresh start.
Yeah, well, I suppose things are able to return to what they once were.
Not those times, Watson. Mrs. Hudson has retired to Ireland. Inspector Forbes now has his own family. And of course yourself. Staying in hiding for goodness knows how long. For once I agree with my brother, it is time for me to leave Baker Street.
So, what are you going to do then, and whereabouts are you going to go?
You remember Professor James Moriarty?
I mean, how could I forget? He's the reason we're in this situation in the first place.
Well, I've been doing some investigating. It will take some time to pin down his exact location, but I believe Switzerland is where he is based.
Right, we'll just be careful, because we both know how dangerous he is.
Yes.
You know, I remember the first case when we were first introduced to him. It was that woman who was being stalked by her ex. Violet Smith, if I remember rightly.
Indeed, you are correct. You know, a couple of years later, I did have to reopen the case of Violet Smith. She returned a few years later to ask for my help.
Really? I didn't know that.
It was the first Christmas, I think, that you were in hiding. She came to see me. She was, again, receiving the cipher notes.
I don't understand. Didn't the stalker fall off the cliff?
He escaped rather too well. But I remember, all those years ago, that one December evening that Violet Smith returned to Baker Street.
I didn't know what to do, Mr. Holmes. I came straight here after I'd opened it.
You did the right thing in doing so, Violet.
All this time I thought I was free from him, and now he's back.
Abe Slaney is dead.
Yet his body was never found, was it, Mr. Holmes?
Could you perhaps tell me what this cipher note says?
Well, that is quite simple. He has asked for my hand in marriage.
Marriage? He picks his moments, doesn't he?
Quite right.
I mean, how long has it been? 18 months since you last heard of him? I mean, what has changed?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Oh, now please, Miss Smith. I never guess. Now, it has been quite a while since I heard of this case. So could you please remind me, why is it that you and Slaney used cipher notes?
My father was never happy with mine and Slaney's relationship. We had to write to each other secretly using notes, such as to arrange meeting times and places, etc.
And in the end, what happened? What made you both separate?
My father died, and me and Slaney, we finished our relationship so that my father could rest in peace.
Oh yes, I recollect of this now.
The thing is, Mr. Holmes...
Oh please, call me Sherlock.
The thing is, Sherlock, I don't know what to do.
Well, there is the easy option, of course, and that is to accept his marriage proposal.
But I don't want to be with him, that's the thing.
My goodness, perhaps his story is something for the Jeremy Kyle show.
Please do not take amusement from this.
Apologies.
I was expecting more from you, to be honest.
What? Do you mean to say you want my help?
Well, yes, that is the reason why I'm here.
Oh, well, you should have said. Oh, I am so, so happy. I'm just so excited. You do not know what this means to me.
Sherlock!
Sorry.
What is it that I am to do?
Right, yes. Of course. So, are you currently aware that anyone followed you here today?
No, I don't think so.
And is that a certainty?
Well, no. There was a few other people on the train.
So there is a possibility?
I guess there is, yeah.
Very well. I shall reopen your case.
Thank you.
The case of Violet Smith is reopened. Now this is what we are going to do.
So what did you do after that?
My plan was as similar to our original one. I went to the manor and hid in the bushes to see if anyone was following her.
And what did you see?
Nothing. There was no trace whatsoever that anyone was there.
Oh, right, I see.
I went back the day after that and the day after that, but still... there was no trace of anyone watching her.
But yet, somebody still sent her the cipher note.
Indeed. A cipher in which only her and her follower knew about. Things returned to normal for a couple of weeks after that, and I heard nothing from Violet. That was until Christmas morning, when a text message I received sent everything into danger.
Because I love you, Violet.
Got a funny way of showing it. You know, when I left you, I did it for my father, so he could rest in peace.
You cannot let your father come between us. We have something special between us.
Yes, it's a shame it isn't a wall. How do you expect me to love a man who murders my employer stalks me and kidnaps me.
Carruthers was a mistake. He got in the way.
Even so, I cannot love you after everything you've done, and I will never marry you.
You don't have any choice, Violet. I planned the whole thing.
Well, it won't happen. I will refuse.
Violet, my dear, you're going to spend the rest of your life with me, no matter what you do.
No, I bloody well won't.
Don't try my patience. You won't like me when I'm angry.
I don't like you when you're not. There'll be no difference, no matter what mood you're in.
Violet, stop this. We can be together now. Fine. Have it your way. If I can't have you, nobody can. We can be together on the other side.
No. No, please. Please, no. Please.
Violet! Violet Smith!
I'm so sorry, Violet.
Please don't do it.
No. Violet, run.
I told you to stay away from us, Mr. Holmes.
And yet I couldn't resist.
And now you must face the consequences. Goodbye, Mr. Holmes. Violet! Come out wherever you are! Should have run faster, Violet.
Come along, Violet. The game is over.
Wow, Holmes. That sounds like a very eventful Christmas.
Your observation continues to be contagious.
But what I don't get is, didn't you get shot? I mean, you're the famous Sherlock Holmes, I know, but not even you could survive that.
In my upper pocket was my mobile phone. The gun that Slaney used wasn't a very powerful one. Therefore, the mobile phone stopped the bullet from piercing into me.
Good Lord. You got off lightly there, Holmes.
Yeah.
Well, at least Violet can sleep easy now, knowing that she's not under any sort of threat. So, did she marry in the end or not?
She did. She lives a very happy life now. Even now, she still sends me a card every Christmas.
Oh, lovely. Well, listen, Holmes. It's near to midnight over here. Suppose it's end of a terrible year for us all.
2021. Let us all wish for a much better year.
I know you're probably thinking that you're alone right now, but we are not ashamed of you, Sherlock. And actually, I would go as far as to say we are so proud of you, mate. Seriously, we are dead proud of you. Mrs. Hudson, Inspector Forbes, everybody. And I can say this with all certainty. There isn't a single person on this planet that wouldn't want to shake your hand because of the things that you have done. So just remember, Sherlock, you are loved and always will be.
Thank you.
Anyways, the very best of luck to your homes. Happy New Year.
And many happy returns, my dear Watson.
See you in a bit, mate. Bye.